Hi, my name is Sophie Hellyer. I'm a surfer, environmentalist, and the founder of Rise Fierce, which is a global cold water swimming community. I'm here today to talk to you about plastic-free periods. So, plastic pollution has quickly become one of the biggest environmental challenges facing us today, and one that I'm sure we're all well aware of. Globally, we've already created 8.3 billion metric tons of plastic, which we know doesn't break down for hundreds, if not thousands of years, and it's killing wildlife and damaging our ecosystem. If you think of the biggest animal in the world, the blue whale, a blue whale grows up to 173 tons. So we've produced the same amount of plastic as roughly 50 million blue whales. Can you imagine that in our oceans? Let that sink in for a minute. And now add to that the fact that plastic production is expected to double over the next 20 years and nearly quadruple by 2050. One of the plastic items contributing to that pile is conventional period products. Most are single use, and they often contain plastic, bleach, and other harmful chemicals. And a lot of these products are outliving the people that use them. The average person who has periods spends about 3,000 days bleeding in their life. That equates to roughly 12,000 pads or tampons in the bin. 200,000 tons of period waste is landfilled in the UK every year. And the period waste that doesn't make it to landfill is often flushed down the toilets. In the UK, it's estimated that 2.5 million tampons and 1.4 million sanitary pads are flushed down the toilet every single day. That's 2.5 million tampons a day. That's a lot of waste per person sitting in landfill or floating around in the ocean. I know about this personally all too well. After I was surfing one day, I was paddling for a wave and a used sanitary pad landed on my face. Not nice. We now know that 8.5% of beach plastics in the UK come from our bathrooms, and period products are now the fifth most common plastic found on our beaches. So period plastics are more of a problem than plastic straws, disposable cups, balloons, and even plastic bags. What if we could replace these disposable toxic period products with ones that are better for the ocean, for our wallets, and for our bodies? Well, the good news is that we can. The groundswell of concern around single-use period products has resulted in a push for environmental, more sustainable alternatives. And as well as them being more sustainable, period products normally cost us around £4,800 over our menstruating life. But by switching to reusable alternatives, we can save up to 94% of what our lifetime spend would be on disposables. So I'm going to talk you through a few of those alternatives. Menstrual cups, firstly, have been around for decades, but they've risen in popularity thanks to a mix of environmentalism, body awareness, period positivity, and good old social media. The cup is having a bit of a moment. So they're usually made from bendy medical grade silicone. They're bell-shaped device that sits in the vaginal canal, and it collects the blood rather than absorbing it like a traditional tampon. Menstrual cups are perfect for people on the move with an active lifestyle. If you're traveling, someone like me who does a lot of sport, and a menstrual cup should last you like 5 to 10 years, and so provide the biggest cost saving of all of the plastic-free options available. If anyone's wondering how on earth you use this, when you're on your period, you just fold it, you pop it inside yourself. It sits there and collects the blood for around 8 hours or 12 hours, depending what brand you're using. And then you take it out, empty it, rinse it, and reuse it. And that's the key with these, that you're reusing them. So you're not chucking tampons down the toilet that are gonna find their way into the oceans. Pros of menstrual cups, I've just said they're super long lasting. They can last for like many years if you take care of it. Depending on what brand you use, you can leave them in for 8 or 12 hours. There's no waste at all other than a cardboard box that it comes in when you first buy it. And it's better value than most disposable products in the long run. I will say the cons are that it's a little bit more fiddly to get used to. You obviously have to wash and clean them, and the menstrual cup doesn't work for everybody, so you can't always wear it if you have a coil or an IUD. Next up, period pants. So period pants are super comfy, absorbent underwear that you can wash and reuse. They last for 2 to 3 years, and they come in every style you can imagine. These are mine. They work thanks to clever textile innovations that combine fluid absorbent and fluid repellent materials together. They basically have three layers. So the inner layer wicks moisture away from the body, so it's moving that fluid away into the middle layer. The middle layer is then super absorbent, water-loving material. It holds onto the fluid, and the outer layer is a water impermeable, so it stops the period seeping onto your clothes. The cons, I guess, are that the initial spend is slightly higher, and also I'd say they take quite a long time to dry, so you do need multiple pairs for your cycle. Next up, reusable period pads. So a traditional big brand pack of like 14 period pads contains the same amount of plastic as 5 carrier bags. Reusable pads are used in the same way as you'd use a disposable pad, but they aren't squeaky or sticky, and they can be washed again and reused for years. They're basically like a soft, comfortable piece material pad which you wash after use, and they're available in loads of different absorbencies, colourful designs, different sizes and styles as well. Next up is organic cotton tampons. So these are disposable. They're just like the regular tampons, but because they're made from organic cotton, they don't contain nasty chemicals or plastic. I do recommend, if you're opting for ones with an applicator, that you opt for a cardboard applicator over a bioplastic applicator, as the cardboard is much more eco-friendly. Fifth on my list is the reusable tampon applicator. It's made by a brand called Dame, and it's used in the same way as another tampon applicator. You just wash it and reuse it, and they last for up to 10 years. Another reason why I think it's super important that we just have this chat and talk about periods is that if we normalize talking about periods, it's a step towards ending period poverty. So in period poverty, 1 in 5 girls in the UK are missing school at the moment because they just can't afford period products. And those numbers look far, far worse in the global south and other places in the world. So talk about periods. If you're a person who has periods, maybe think about switching to a plastic-free option. And thank you for listening.